Hi students, a very good morning. Today we continue the shape of the orbital. In the last session we discussed the variation of wave function psi with respect to the distance r. As we know that the wave function can be represented by the product of two function, radial wave function and the angular wave function. And we understand that the graph, the plots of 1s orbital, 2s orbital and 2p orbitals psi versus r. Psi versus r. So today we are going to discuss the boundary diagrams or the shape of the orbital in details. The main point is probability density. Probability density of the electron. Psi has no physical meaning, but psi square has a physical meaning, as we already know. Psi simply represents the amplitude of the wave. But according to German physicist Max Born, psi square is the probability density. According to Max Born, a German physicist, he suggested that psi square gives the probability density of the electron around the nucleus. The wave function, the radial wave function or wave function psi square. If it is radial function, r square. As we know that psi is equal to r of r into a theta and phi. So when we take the psi square, it is also equal to r square. So the radial wave function, the square of radial wave function or square of wave function gives an information about the probability density of electron in a unit volume around the nucleus. So psi square gives the probability density of electron around the nucleus. Are you clear? Yes. So psi square gives the probability of electron at a particular point. For a particular point, electron the probability parayanavarku psi square nu parayana term aanu use cheyam. Psi square can be used. And for s orbital, for s orbital, the probability density is around the nucleus. We have to draw the diagram like this. This is the probability density of the electron. We cannot say 100% probability. The probability is maximum, we have to say 90%. The probability of electron around the nucleus, we cannot say 100%. The maximum is 90%. And all the s orbital, as we know that all the s orbitals are spherically symmetrical. That is the probability density of electron in all direction from the nucleus is same. The probability of finding the electron at a given point or at a given distance is equal in all direction. From the nucleus, suppose it is nucleus. From the nucleus, the probability of finding electron are here, and also here, and here, So the probability of finding electron in s orbital is equal in all distance. Either distance we are looking at, s orbital the probability density is equal. The reason for that. When we draw the variation of psi square as a function of r, variation of psi square as a function of r, we get the plot like this. We get the plot like this. What it means? The probability of this is origin, that means nucleus. This is origin, that means nucleus. So for 1s orbital, this is the psi square versus r diagram for 1s orbital. For 1s orbital, the probability of finding electron is maximum at the nucleus. Okay, for 1s orbital, the probability density is more at the nucleus. You can see in the diagram. And the probability density decreases. Okay, when we move from the nucleus, the probability density decreases and reaching a minimum zero. Okay, so for 1s orbital, the probability density diagram is this one. For 2s orbital, okay, for 2s orbital, psi square raises arm. It is different. It is quite different from the 1s orbital. The probability density decreases and reaching the minimum, that is zero. And again it increases and reaches a maximum. Okay, a small maximum, and again it decreases or approaches zero. And this point, okay, there is the probability of density is equal to zero. Okay, the probability density is equal to zero, that is psi square is equal to zero. The point is known as nodal nodes or spherical node. Or you can write that radial node. Okay, so three important things. It is simply called a nodes. What is node? The probability of finding electron is zero. That is psi square is equal to zero. So at the nodes, psi square is equal to zero. Are you clear? So once again, it is noted that for 1s orbital, the probability of finding electron or the probability density is maximum at the nucleus for 1s orbital. Okay, and it decreases sharply. It decreases sharply when we move from nucleus into a distance. Okay, or when we away from the nucleus. Are you clear? Then, in the case of 2s orbital. Okay, in the case of 2s orbital, the probability density sharply decreases. Okay, this is a sharp decrease. Sharply decreasing. After reaching or it approaches zero, then again it increases. Okay, after reaching or approaches zero, again it increases. And reaching a small maximum it reaches, then it decreases. Here there is a point. Okay, here there is a region in which the probability of finding electron is zero, or probability density is equal to zero. What is probability density? Psi square. Psi square is the probability density. So this point or this region is called nodes. N-O-D-E-S. Okay, nodes. So what are nodes? Nodes are the probability density of electron is equal to zero, or we can say that psi square is equal to zero. Okay, so it is different names are there: nodal surfaces, simply nodes, spherical node, because s orbital is in spherical shape. Okay, spherical shape. Then it is also known as radial waves. Okay, the distance r from the nucleus is equal. Okay, that's why it is also called radial nodes. Okay, in general, ns orbital has n minus 1 nodes. A very important thing. For ns orbital, the number of radial nodes or number of nodal surfaces is equal to n minus 1. So what is the number of or how many nodes for 1s orbital? No nodes, because n is 1. 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. No node for
No, not for 1s orbital.
Okay, 1s orbital is not silam. The number of spherical knot or number of radial knot is equal to n minus 1 for s orbital. Apo 1s orbital n is equal to 1. So 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. So for 1s orbital there is no spherical knot. So there is no knots.
And what about 2s orbital? What about 2s orbital?
2 minus 1.
2 minus 1 that is equal to 1.
For 2s orbital, 1 spherical knot.
Then what about 3s orbital? 3s orbital, 3 minus 1 that is equal to 2.
3s orbital has 2 spherical knot. Okay, so ns orbital, you remember this relation. For ns orbital, the number of spherical knots is equal to n minus 1. Okay, then suppose, okay, I show some shapes. Suppose, this is a 1s orbital. Okay, can you see that's a small ball? Okay, this is a 1s orbital. Suppose it. Then the 2s orbital is bigger than 1s orbital. Okay. And the in between the two area, there is a spheric absence of electron. So we have to write the 2s orbital boundary diagram as like I drew here. So the this is a 1s orbital, a small orbital, and suppose the principal quantum number increases, the size of the orbital also increases. Remember that. And in between, okay, the part reaches zero. And there is no probability of finding electron here. Remember that. Okay, here is no probability of finding electron. Then again the density increases. Again the density increases. And this is known as knot. Okay, for 2s orbital the size is bigger. The size increases with the increasing the principal quantum number. What about 3s orbital? Again it increases. What about 4s orbital? It increases. So if this small ball spherical shape is a 1s orbital, this one is 2s orbital, and this one is a 3s or 4s orbital. Okay, just understand that. What understand from this concept? When the principal quantum number increases, okay, when the principal quantum number increases, the size of the S orbital increases. A very important concept. A very important information. All S orbitals are spherically symmetrical. Remember that. Okay. All S orbitals are spherically symmetrical. That is the probability of finding electron at a given distance is equal in all directions. Okay, either direction is the sphere and the ball center in the same distance in the probability is same. Okay, understand that. Then the size of the S orbital increases when the principal quantum number increases. 1s smaller in size, 2s bigger in size, then 3s or 4s again bigger in size. So size increases when the principal quantum number increases. This is the boundary diagram for the 2s orbital. In between there is a absence of electron density, or there is no probability for finding electron. That reason is called knots. And order of size 4s is bigger than 3s. Is bigger than 2s, is bigger than 1s. Are you clear? The size of the orbital increases by increasing the principal quantum number n. A very important thing. And another information, when we far away from the nucleus, what happens? The probability of finding electron is less. Okay, when the principal quantum number increases, that means we far away from the nucleus. Okay, far away from the nucleus, the probability of electron or the probability density of electron is less. Okay, so next we move to the boundary surface diagrams of p orbitals and d orbitals. First we discuss the boundary surface diagram for the p orbital. The probability density for different orbital gives fairly a good representation of shape of the orbital, as we know that. The probability is maximum 90. Okay. The probability is maximum 90 around the nucleus. We can say 90%, not 100%. Okay. Then, in the case of S orbital, psi square versus R. This is for 1s orbital. Okay. Psi square versus R. Already it is given. Then this also psi square versus R for 2s orbital. What we have to see, near the nucleus the electron density is high and it decreases we move from the nucleus. Here sharply decreases, reaches a minimum, that is zero, approaches zero, and goes to a minimum maximum or small maximum, then decreases. But in the case of p orbital, the p orbital diagram is different from these two. Okay, psi square versus R, the diagram, the probability density versus distance diagram or R diagram is like this. What it means, the P orbital is not in spherical shape. Okay, the boundary surface diagram of the P orbitals are not a spherical shape. Then what is the shape of the p orbital? The shape of the p orbital is dumbbell shape. Okay, the shape of the p orbital is dumbbell in shape. Boys know what is dumbbell. In gymnasium, dumbbells are used to make more muscles. Okay, then the shape of the p orbital is dumbbell shape. There are three p orbitals. Okay, what are the p orbitals? 3p orbitals, px, py and pz orbitals. Px, py and pz orbitals. Okay, suppose this orbital lies in the x axis. Remember that each p orbital having two lobes. Okay. This is one lobe and this one is another lobe. Okay, each p orbital, that means px, py and pz having two lobes. And the two lobes are separated by a plane. Okay, the two lobes are separated by a region of zero probability. You can see here. There is the probability of probability density is zero. Okay, near the nucleus. Near the nucleus, the probability density is zero. Then it increases. Okay, then it increases and then decreases. Are you clear? So the probability density increases and then decreases. So each p orbital having two lobes. The electron density is say in the same lobes. Okay, so p orbitals having two lobes. The two lobes are separated by the region of zero probability of finding electron or zero probability of electrons. And this is known as nodal plane or angular nodes. Nodal planes or angular nodes. non-plane or angular normal. Are you clear? Yes. So, in notebook or in board, we have to represent the p orbitals like this. Three axes. This is x, y, z. Okay. So, we can write this is px. If the x is present in second shell, we can write 2px. And the next one is py. Okay, if the lobes lies in the x axis, it is px. And if the lobes lie in the y axis, it is py. So, we can draw like this. Okay, dumbbell. Then x, y, z axis. X, y, z axis. And if the lobes lie in the z axis. Okay. Three axes are mutually perpendicular. You know that. Three axes are mutually perpendicular. So if the lobes lie in the z direction, we can say that it is p z. Okay, x, y, z. X, y, z. Okay, so I give the three p orbitals in a single model. Okay, this is the three p orbitals. These are green lob. Okay, the green lob is lying in the x direction. The orange is lying in the y direction and the pink is in the z direction. So this is the shape of the p orbitals. We draw separately. Okay, this is px, this one is py, this one is pz. So we draw the orbitals separately, the boundary diagram in the textbook it is shaded. Okay, you can also shade the lobes. No problem. Okay, you shade the lobes. So here it is separately given. Px, Py, Pz. Okay, Px is lying in the x axis, Py is lying in the y axis, and Pz is lying in the z axis. Okay, this is 3p orbitals. 3p orbitals in a main shell or in a shell is like this. Are you clear? You can also make the model by using balloon. Okay, this is a simple model. Okay, so now the orange balloon is in the x direction, a green is in the y direction, and a pink is in. Okay, anyway, any direction you can choose. So this is the shape of the p orbital. Are you clear? Yes. Then this is separately made. Okay. So how many nodal planes for the p orbital? Here is only one. Okay. This is the nodal plane for px, and this is the nodal plane for the py. And what about this? This direction, okay. This is z, the plane is like xy plane, okay. The nodal plane is xy plane. If it is x direction, the nodal plane is yz plane. Okay, so for an orbital, a very simple and direct relation. For an orbital, the number of nodal planes or number of angular nodes. So in the case of p orbital, we can say that nodal planes or angular nodes for any orbital. Okay, for any orbital, the number of nodal planes is equal to azimuthal quantum number. For any orbital, the number of nodal plane or angular node is equal to its azimuthal quantum number. So, what is the number of nodal plane for s orbital, no nodes. Okay, non-ordered plane because it has l is equal to 0. For s orbital, l is equal to 0. That's why s orbital has no nodal plane. S orbital has nodes, spherical nodes or radial nodes. And remember relation, s orbital having ns orbital having n minus 1 spherical node. A very important relation. Okay, ns orbital has n minus 1 spherical node. For any orbital, the number of nodal plane or number of angular nodes is equal to its azimuthal quantum number. So for p orbital, okay, for p orbital nodal plane, number of nodal plane is equal to 1, since l is equal to 1 for p orbital. For p orbital l is equal to 1, that's why the number of nodal planes or angular node is equal to 1. Is there any radial node for p orbital? Okay. Yes. For 2p orbital, there is no nodal radial nodes. Okay. For 2p orbital, there is no radial node. To determine the radial node of a orbital, there is a relation. The number of radial nodes is equal to n minus l minus 1. For any orbital, this relation you can apply into any orbital. So let's take 2p orbital. What is the number of nodal plane? Number of nodal plane is equal to 2p. Principal quantum number 2. And L4p is 1 and minus 1, so 0. For 2p orbital, the number of spherical node is equal to 0, or number of radial node is equal to 0. Then let's consider another 3p orbital. For 3p orbital, nodal plane is equal to 3 minus, okay, principal quantum number 3. For p orbital it is 1 and minus 1, that is 1. For p orbital, the spherical node is equal to 1. And generally, for p orbital, nodal planes is equal to n minus 2. Okay, nodal plane is equal to n minus 2. Back into the 2p orbital, 2 minus 2, 0. 2 minus 2, 0. Okay, for 3p orbital, 3 minus 2, 1. So generally, we have to say that the number of nodal plane or angular node for p orbital is equal to n minus 2. Are you clear? And again, the shape and the size. Shape is dumbbell in shape. The size of the p orbital is 4p is bigger than 3p is bigger than 2p. Is there a p orbital in first shell? No. Okay, if n is equal to 1, principal quantum number n is equal to 1, l cannot be 1. N is equal to 1. L cannot accept the value 1. So that's why there is no 1p orbital. P orbital start from 2, 3, 4, etc. energy level. 2p orbital is smaller. Okay. If suppose this is 2p orbital. What about the 3p orbital? A big blob. Okay, big blob. 4p, another big blob. In between two lobs, there is a spherical node. So that's about the p orbital. Hope you understand the things. Okay. So in the next section, we will discuss the shape of the d orbital. Okay. You please go through the textbook. In textbook, the information given you read it, sometimes you feel difficulty, that's not a matter. Any doubt you can ask. Okay, so next day we will discuss the shape of the d orbitals and the energies of different orbitals. Thank you.